I'm Roz, and I am a clinical psychologist by training, and I am currently the clinical lead of the psilocybin for depression study at Imperial College. So I've thought for a long time about whether or not to join the advisory board of synthesis. Essentially, from what I can see synthesis is doing, is trying to develop a very, very effective, safe, and beautiful way of exploring psilocybin therapy. And it is not cutting any corners. And of course then that's going to be expensive. But having met the people from synthesis and also having referred some of our participants there and had colleagues that have been there and just knowing other people that have been, I feel sure that it's a great thing. I'm glad it exists. And ultimately I know that their reason for doing it isn't about making profit. It's about making psychedelic therapy accessible for people and building good practices and communities too. So I think that, it's my ethical standpoint is shared by them. One of the very difficult parts of my work is when people have psilocybin treatment with us and it works and then they can't access it. And it's really nice to know that there's somewhere I can recommend people go. And that I can recommend people going knowing that I know people that have been. I haven't been myself yet, I really want to. I will as soon as I can make the time. But that I know that people have experienced the same level of care that we try to provide, and that it's a very similar model. So it's not saying, somebody from our study was probably unlikely to want to go and do ayahuasca in Peru because they can't get there, and it's a completely different worldview and different model. But the synthesis model is one that I feel that we have common ground. It's the same kind of way of working. So it's people aren't jumping from one world to another, it's continuing their work. Probably from doing the psychedelic work, I've got more in tune with my own body. So part of the accept, connect and body model is accepting pain, going towards it, connecting to yourself and other people and the embodiment aspect of that process. And through it, I've got much more in touch with my body. I think in the West we're quite heady. I'm very heady person, but I've got more in touch with my body. I've got more in touch with my gut feelings. And so I think one of the things I can help with is that I, in terms of kind of vision and direction, I get a very, very strong gut sense. And it's only my own gut sense, so it might not be right for everybody, but I get my own very strong gut sense of what is in the direction of flourishing and health and connection, and what is in a direction of not. So I think that gut sense is something that everyone on our team, we're all starting to develop it, and that's something that I would like to be, that I think can be useful in some way in terms of kind of directions perhaps. But maybe my most useful thing will be that synthesis, because of the setup, will be taking people who are exploring and maybe in crisis in their personal lives, but they're not psychiatric patients, because of things to do with insurance and how it all works, I guess. I mean, I'm not sure what plans are for the future, but right now, Imperial, because of our insurance and because of our psychiatric setup and hospital setup, we can accept people with psychiatric diagnoses, and synthesis can't. And so I see that the experience we have with that is useful and helpful.